Hello, everyone. Welcome to SAP CodeTalk. I'm Sheena, and I'm a developer advocate at SAP. So today, we have a very special guest on SAP CodeTalk, Andrea Schlotthauer. So whoever is active on SAP community, her name is not new. We have seen numerous blog posts from Andrea about ABAP Core Data Services. So she is currently with the ABAP platform team and is focusing on ABAP Core Data Services. So welcome, Andrea, to SAP CodeTalk.
Hi, Sheena. I'm glad to be here. Thank you for the nice introduction.
Okay, so let's get started. So, Andrea, we would like to know more about yourself. So, could you please introduce yourself for our audience and also let us know how you started working with ABAP Core Data Services?
Yeah, sure. I currently work at BTP ABAP at the integration and enablement team as a user assistance developer. And my day-to-day business is to write documentation such as the ABAP keyword documentation, so reference documentation, and also developer guides that are published on SAP Help Portal. And additionally, I participate in rollout activities on SAP Community, as you mentioned. So I'm regularly blogging release news about the latest features of ABAP Core Data Services. And I also sometimes hold workshops to internal and external audiences, and my team tests and documents and rolls out different aspects of the ABAP cloud development model. And my area of expertise in this team is ABAP Core Data Services.
Well, that's wonderful, Andrea. So can you also explain the scope and advantages of using ABAP Core Data Services and why developers should use this technology?
Yes, sure. ABAP Core Data Services is a technology for defining and consuming semantically rich data models that are optimized to run on the SAP HANA database. It's one of the techniques that ABAP provides for code push down to fully leverage the computing power and advanced libraries of the SAP HANA database. It offers advanced capabilities for building data models in ABAP, including access control, extensibility, and reuse modeling. In particular, in the context of ABAP Cloud, the development effort for ABAP Core Data Services has gained new momentum and new features are being added constantly to improve the productivity, consumability, performance, and interoperability of ABAP data models and to provide maximum ease of use to developers.
Okay, great. And now we are talking more about cloud everywhere, right? So can you also explain ABAP Core Data Services in the context of ABAP Cloud?
Yes, of course, ABAP Core Data Services is a part of the Golden Path technology recommendation for data modeling in the ABAP Cloud development model. ABAP data models built with ABAP Core Data Services can be used for different programming aspects of ABAP Cloud. The most prominent use cases are building transactional applications with the RESTful ABAP Application Programming Model, RAP for short, and the second important use case is building multidimensional data models for analytical reporting. And then there's also the CDS-based enterprise search. You can optimize your CDS data model so it can be used in analysis and search scenarios. For example, on SAP Fiori Launchpad. And then CDS also supports data integration, so you can easily exchange data across system boundaries. So ABAP Core Data Services is the heart of ABAP Cloud applications. Using ABAP Cloud means using ABAP CDS.
Yes, that's right. Yeah, and that's the future too. So that's interesting, Andrea. So can you also give us some examples or some use cases of ABAP CodeTalk?
Yeah, I have already mentioned some of the use cases, but I can go into some more details of the most important ones. So firstly, let me mention the RESTful ABAP application programming model. It's the technology recommendation for building transactional applications with ABAP. And the data modeling layer is done with ABAP core data, ABAP core data services. And in the context of RAP, you can expose your data model as an OData service for an SAP Fiori application.
Okay.
So that's the first one. And then there are also dedicated CDS entities available for modeling analytical queries. These queries aim at evaluating and aggregating large amounts of data to provide answers to business questions. And there's a special set of syntax features and annotations available, in particular for analytical reports and also an own service model infrastructure. So these analytical queries can be exposed with the information access protocol for consumption by analytical clients such as SAP Analytics Cloud. And the third very important use case is the CDS-based enterprise search. There's a special set of enterprise search annotations that you can use in your data model to optimize it for analysis and search scenarios on SAP Fiori Launchpad. So these are three very important use cases for ABAP Core Data Services in the ABAP Cloud development model.
Okay, great. That's quite a lot. Okay, so that's a lot of information, Andrea. Thank you so much. Maybe our audience would like to know more information about ABAP CodeTalk services and also the development news, like what's coming up next. So where can we find all this information and more about the development news from your ABAP CodeTalk services team?
So my team in particular delivers a lot of documentation and rollout material and also roadmap information. For example, if you are programming in ABAP development tools, you can click the F1 button on a keyword, and then this is the most easy way to reach the ABAP keyword documentation. So all the language features of ABAP Core Data Services are explained there. And then you can also go on SAP Help Portal and search for ABAP data models. And there you find the developer guide that describes describes the best practices for data modeling with ABAP Core Data Services. And it also provides links to the end-to-end development guides, for example, for RAP and ABAP Analytics. Then on SAP Community, there are many colleagues actively blogging about core data services. And our product management is currently designing an own landing page for ABAP Core Data Services. But at the moment, for example, you find a blog post that's called Getting Started with ABAP Core Data Services that collects material and points to many very useful resources. And also there's the SAP Tutorial Navigator, where there are many tutorials about CDS that guide beginners through their first steps when creating CDS entities. And the last thing that I would like to mention here is a YouTube channel. It's called SAP Developers, and there's a playlist called ABAP Cloud, and there you find short videos that introduce ABAP Cloud features. It's not only ABAP Core Data Services, but there are also ABAP CDS features being introduced. And you will also find the links to these resources in the video description.
Yes. Yeah, thank you so much, Andrea. So there are many links, maybe just for our audience. We will be attaching all these links in the description of this particular video. And we also have started a TechBytes series on core data services. The first one is out today morning, so don't forget to check it out. The rest of the series will be out in the coming weeks. So we'll be providing all this information in the description box below, so you can check it out for more details. So, Andrea, thank you so much for your time, man. It was a very good conversation with you about ABAP Core Data Services. And it was a pleasure to have you on the SAP Code Talk. I'm sure our audience got some very good insights about Core Data Services on ABAP. So thank you for watching us.
Thanks, Sina. It was my pleasure. Bye.